Welcome back to the channel! So, I'm stuck in the stupid ass cave or whatever the flip it is. However, in my stuckness, I thought I'm gonna, you know, tell another story of my messed up family. We're gonna family, but you know, people, I don't know. Okay, so my mission is, I think, to ultimately get, yeah, since fast travel does not exist in this game, I will tell a story in the meantime as I'm running, like a person trying to find his way out, maybe not ever, and then hopefully restart, and then, you know, I'll just fucking restart the game and appear on the outside. I don't think it will work like that. If that's the way out, I will be pissed off at myself. Because I've been stuck here, I think, for 30 minutes now. But anyway, I digress. Story time with Knoam. So, my aunt in the previous story that I told you guys, my aunt is a badass motherfucker. And I think, I'm not sure, I think
this guardian was destroyed long ago.
She used to be a nurse, as a occupational situation. I'm not 100% sure, but this day it's me, my cousin, my two brothers, and our niece. So my aunt decided, the previous night, to tell her that when she comes home, my niece isn't supposed to be messing around and playing with us. So, since after school, we go to my grandmother's house, and they live. Oh, for fuck's sake. And they lived with my grandmother. And we decided, most like, we're gonna stay there until we get picked up by our father, whatever. So, the first night, we all saw her get a beating from her mother, and it was obviously the funniest thing ever. Had the best laughs ever. Try this. Ah, for fuck's sake! And then
the Zepho crafted this artifact as an offering to the wind. It was destroyed intentionally for some reason.
So yeah, when the time came for her to come home, I'm standing in the passage of where everybody was playing in. So remember, I'm also playing with all of them, and my aunt came in pissed off when she saw her. So I just saw two things happening: my niece running past me and a metal spoon flying past me. With no lie, I'm not bullshitting. Whoever remembers the story can confirm that this shit happened. My aunt threw her against her ear, like clean. Pow, pow. And I'm talking about that. He was like, motherfucker. So, the following night, following day, so we saw her at school, and then her ear was all patched up and whatever was down. So,
I need some meds, BD1.
For fuck's sake. So her ear was all patched up and shit. Then my cousin started making fun of her and saying, ah, she's gonna have one ear for the rest of her life and she won't be able to hear on the one side, blah blah blah. So again, we go to my grandmother's after school and we ended up playing there. Again. Now we're timing my aunt, eh? We're timing my aunt to the point to where if she comes home, my niece, I think it's niece, I'm not sure, niece or cousin, I can't deal with the thing right now. But she was supposed to be gone, she was supposed to be at the back cleaning or just doing homework. So my aunt gave us a bag of fruit, but it's dried fruit. So you get the one piece of dried fruit that is the shape of a ear, and then my cousin, the ingenious motherfucker that he is, told all of us that the fruit that we are eating is made of her ear. And the funny thing is, my niece couldn't confirm or deny this whole situation, firstly, and then secondly, because of my aunt's being a nurse, we just went with it. We just went with the whole situation that this motherfucker is going to eat ears, because no one questioned why one ear will become many ears, like a bag of ears the following night. No one. And I was like, yeah, fuck, I was a stupid ass kid growing up, and I'm still stuck. Fuck off! And then, because of what happened, we ended up never trusting our cousin ever again because of his shit. Because he had a bag of fruit where everybody else was just looking at this motherfucker and he's standing there eating it with a smirk on his face. I'm like, God, oh fuck. It looks so lekker to eat, but what can a bra do? You got duped into not eating. Got duped into not eating fruit. But just wanted to share that story. Firstly. Secondly, fuck being stuck in this cave. And I'll see you hopefully when I'm not stuck in this flipping cave again. Because I'm getting annoyed now. And this stupid map isn't really saying anything. Anyway, enjoy, thank you for watching, and if you like the stories, let me know, I will, you know, dig deep and see if there's something else I can talk about, because, I mean, like, there's a lot of funny shit. So, enjoy, bye.